getting up in the morning with the aim of studying a lot, but not reaching the goal. If this story sounds familiar to you, then hang on. Watch the full video and change the way you study. Hello and welcome to my channel, The Conceptual Codon. In this video, I will discuss about some efficacious techniques of studying and how to beat procrastination. So the base of a productive day begins from the day before. Yes, it is the most important part, the planning. Just take a mere 10 minutes at the night to plan your tomorrow and make sure you write it down in a piece of paper. You can use sticky notes for this purpose as well. And the best way, if you want to take this as a permanent method, you can download the app called TickTick and you can plan your day in advance. Once you have planned your tomorrow, after getting up in the morning, you won't have to worry about things like, what am I going to study today? Or should I read this chapter or that? Believe me, without a study plan, we tend to waste a good 1 to 2 hours in the morning, and that is the most efficacious time. And we waste deciding what to study and scrolling social media out of frustration. Now, as you have made a study plan before, all you have to do is follow the study plan during the day. Now, during the day, your mind may tell you to improvise the plan and skip a chapter as it is too hard. Look, the basic idea of making a study plan at the night before is at that time you can think objectively. So make a plan which you can follow and don't. Let me repeat, do not improvise or change the plan during a day, so stay strong. On some days, precisely on the first day of the habit, you may finish your task quite early. That is due to enthusiasm of starting something new, and there will be an urge to study more. But here is a tip, do not overshoot. If you have finished early, maybe watch a movie or spend some quality time with family and friends. Because if you overshoot on the first day, the idea of violating or changing the routine will be inculcated in your brain. And on the next day, you may be thinking, I studied more than my routine yesterday, so I should take a break today and study less, and I will surely cover it tomorrow. But let me tell you, like this, you will undershoot more often than overshooting. Unless, of course, if you have underestimated yourself and made an easier routine on the first day and constantly overshooting, then make a routine appropriate to your capacity. Knowing the appropriate capacity may take about 3 to 4 days. Now coming to the second part, how to concentrate on studies while studying. In simpler words, how to beat procrastination. Here comes the Pomodoro technique. It is a widely used technique to concentrate on studies. The basic idea is, when we are starting to read a chapter, sometimes we get overwhelmed by the sheer vastness of the chapter or the subject. But if we divide the chapter into some small chunks and complete each chunk in an 1 hour time interval, it looks easier and most importantly, it seems doable. You can customize the time interval, but I personally prefer 1 hour study session followed by a 30 minute break, then another 1 hour session. In the 1 hour study session, for the first 50 minutes, study a thing and revise it once in the last 10 minutes. Believe me, it is more efficacious than what you are thinking now. Repeat the 1 hour study and 30 minute break cycle at least 6 to 8 times a day to get 6 to 8 hours study time. You can always increase the cycles to increase the study time as per your need. According to me, the best Pomodoro app is Forest. Here you plant a tree and study, and the tree will be grown after your study session. And if you leave the app, unfortunately the tree will die. You can also study along with your friends and join their sessions. I have a Telegram group where I conduct study sessions every day and other fun competitions too. Feel free to join. The link is given in the description.
If you liked the video, do like, comment and share. To watch more conceptual videos like this, please subscribe.